Hello, students. Welcome back. So today I have some important career advice and tips that I want to share with you. Whether you are a school student, college undergrad, or even entering university for graduation, I hope this session will be very useful for you. So keep an eye out for the end of this session and don't forget to leave your valuable feedback in the comment section, okay? Before proceeding further, let me just reveal you one more thing that whatever I am going to deliver to you today now is not scripted. So I am just going to say whatever comes to my mind. As such, I didn't make any points, yeah? So the first tip that I want to say to you is about one of the most important aspects in today's competitive world is staying up to date with the latest technology and new developments. In fact, this will probably be your most valuable skill in moving forward. It is because once you venture out into the working world, you are going to come across older people or perhaps I would say senior individuals who have more experience than you, which is quite natural indeed. While they're older than you and might be experienced most, but the advantage you have compared to them is you are more attuned to learn new stuff, latest technology that could be harder for them to keep up. It is because as one gets older, they would have a really tough time grasping new things. Many seniors are just incapable of learning new stuff like new programming languages, new softwares. But when you are in your youth, you have a different mindset. You have this natural ability to remain up to date with any of these kind of things. Therefore, in order to relevant to the times, you should strongly focus on things like today, everybody is discussing about audiovisual technology, GPS tracking, energy saving schemes, which is itself a big issue, and many other fascinating things driven by artificial intelligence technology. Being in your youth at this time, you have the opportunity and energy to learn any of these things quite easily, which can ultimately be a game changer and transform your career. You can boost your career in the modern tech industry by gaining skills over any one of these things. For what I have seen and experienced over the years that people after a certain age lack the drive for learning new skills, adapting to new technology. For example, you may have noticed that your grandparent do not even know properly how to operate a smartphone. But look at yourself. You know how to operate an iPhone, a MacBook, and probably you don't even bother to go through the manual book in your first attempt. Am I right? It is because the process of learning becomes more challenging as you age. Our brain is affected by certain changes in neurons that lead to the slowing down of the signals carrying thoughts. So long story short, I am trying to convey this idea that since you are in your youth, this is the wonderful time for you to learn new technology in depth as much as possible. Do multitasking. So you should keep up with the cutting edge technology to improve yourself and stay updated. Okay, so now you have started learning a new skill. Your very next step would be to build a network related to your field in order to showcase your work. For example, if you have started learning some programming languages, now I am citing this just for an example. If you do not like programming, it is absolutely fine. There are lots of lucrative career opportunities available in this universe. And once you have started to grow your interest in any one of this, what would be your next step? And how should you proceed? I am just answering that question by citing the example of a programmer. So whatever steps I am suggesting here, you should try to apply that in your field also. The steps will remain same, only the variables are different. That's all. So let's say you have started growing interest in programming. Then the very next step would be to participate in different competitions. There are plenty of online and offline competitions organized by different industries these days. So take part in them and don't get panic in this way. Oh, if I fail, what will happen? Everything will be fine. As an amateur, you will probably fail. That is natural. Unless you are extremely talented and unbelievably hardworking. But the most important thing is, by participating in this sort of activities, you will gradually gain a lot of experience and come across various personalities. And then suddenly one day you will discover that you have become a known face to many people. Eventually, you will be able to build a strong network that can open a number of doors for you to get a decent job very quickly. It will appear to people that despite being failing multiple times, you are still participating in the competitions. And in this way, without your awareness, your perseverance will develop a magnetic personality of yourself. Here's a very important point to mention, that failure very often breaks your self-confidence, makes you feel insecure, and you feel like isolating yourself from the outside world. You begin to think that everybody is thinking yourself as a dumb, as a stupid. But let me share you one biggest secret of the universe is, there is no one who literally cares about your success or failure, okay? Success or failure, both are one-night drama, because both lasts for one night only. The very next morning, you will observe that almost 60% of the population has already forgotten about that. It is the nature of human intelligence. Whether you succeed or fail, it is 100% yours alone. Maybe your parents share 40 to 60% at max, but at the end of the day, it is 100% solely up to you. So don't get distracted by outside noise, that what people are thinking, what they are saying. They are thinking nothing about you. In fact, people do not have enough time to think for you actually, because everybody has their own problem in their life. So work upon yourself, take time, develop your skill, develop your attitude, and try to maintain a good vibe. It is very important. Along with developing skills, I would also recommend that you focus on communication skills and especially practice public speaking. Suppose you are an introverted person, a very shy type guy, finding it difficult to mingle very quickly. Then what should you do? Well, first you should practice delivering speech in front of the mirror. And one of the most effective ways to do this is to practice from an outline. Don't memorize anything. You know what? Whenever you are delivering speech, you should sound very conversational, okay? Your listeners don't want you to sound like you memorize everything. For example, if I give a talk like this, let's say a topic has given, say anything like, for example, ChatGPT, which is very famous these days. So if I speak like this, ChatGPT is a natural language processing skills driven by artificial intelligence technology. It has built by OpenAI software. It is such an amazing software such that any people can have a human-like conversations with a chatbot. It can answer any questions, compose essays and emails, and also helps us to writing longer codes. On top of that, it is now freely available for public usage because OpenAI is in its research and gathering public feedback. Tell me, how engaging do you find this? Not at all, isn't it, sir? Now observe that I will deliver the same content in this way. ChatGPT is a natural language processing tool powered by artificial intelligence technology that allows you to have a human-like conversations with the chatbots. As well as answering questions, the language model can assist you with tasks such as composing emails, essays, and even writing longer codes. On top of that, this amazing software is now freely available for public usage because OpenAI is now in its research and gathering public feedback. Wouldn't you agree that this one is more engaging and makes you want to learn more about ChatGPT? Well, so what you need to do is practice delivering speech 10 times, 100 times, as much as possible in front of the mirror, in front of your family, in front of your friends. And the more you practice, the more confident you will become. After a certain period of time, you will see that you are able to deliver speech on any topic. Even though you do not have sufficient knowledge to that, you will do some Google research, tick, 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 and then you will deliver a wonderful speech which looks more conversational and more engaging to the listeners. Another important point I want to add in this context is, if you are giving a PowerPoint presentation, then make sure to make it concise and to the point. Overloading PowerPoint presentations can lose the audience attention because it may happen you fail to pass the important information. You need a good balance between what to write on the slides and what to say so that listeners can find it most effective to figure out, okay? So in today's world, good presentation skills and public speaking skills are a must-have quality, okay? In case you are not very interactive by nature, you should seriously work upon this to develop yourself, and feel free to do any sort of experiments with any topic, new topic. And don't get nervous if you make a mistake while delivering speech. And let me reveal you this secret that the majority of listeners are focused to your personality and style of your delivery. Having a good content is definitely important. There is no question about that. But how you deliver, it matters much more. So exercise on this and definitely you will improve. Yes? Okay, so I will end this session and I wish you all the best. And thank you for watching this. So see you in the next session. Till then, bye.